الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين. My beloved brothers and sisters, we speak about the giant, the great Abu Bakr today, رضي الله عنه. Abu Bakr رضي الله عنه's life is so intense that let alone one day, if I take the entire 30 days of Ramadan and I only throw light over his life, it will be less for me. Then what you ask me to do justice in 10 minutes of the life of Abu Bakr radiyallahu anhu. My beloveds, he was a friend of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam in his young days. He grew up with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. When Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wasallam presented this beautiful deen to all his friends, they would not take it up. If anyone jumped at it, embraced it with no questions asked, was Sayyidina Abu Bakr radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. Not only did he accept Islam, but Sayyidina Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu became the first da'i of Islam, going and knocking the doors of all influential people and calling them to the deen of Allah. Most of the Ashara Mubashara, they are the 10 famous Sahaba that Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that they will be the first ones to enter Jannah. Most of them accepted Islam on the hands of Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu. Uthman radiallahu anhu, Talha radiallahu anhu, Zubair radiallahu anhu, Abdurrahman bin Auf radiallahu anhu are all the products of the hands of Sayyidina Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu. My beloveds, he grew up in Medina, Makkatul Mukarrama, and he faced the tyranny of the Kuffar and the Quraysh, being the confidant and the supporter of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He was the third person, some say the second person, to accept the deen of Allah. After Khadija radiallahu anha, he was the first male to accept Islam, whilst Ali radiallahu anhu was the first youngster to accept Islam. My beloved, subhanallah, Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu was a rich man. He spent all his money, the support of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And that's why the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he was leaving this world, he said, "Whoever done any favor to me, I have paid him back. Illa Abu Bakr, except Abu Bakr. For verily, I do not have the means in this world to pay him back. His reward will truly be only by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala." My beloved, subhanallah, they leashed out tyranny and they leashed out punishments on Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu like never before. Many a times he would go and he saw them hurting the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And his exact words were copied by Allah and pasted in the Quran. أَتَقْتُلُونَ رَجُلًا أَن يَقُولَ رَبِّيَ اللَّهِ. Are you trying to kill a man because he says my Rabb is Allah? Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu said these words to the Quraysh when they were mishandling the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They turned their anger from the Prophet to Abu Bakr. They said, wallahi, they hit Abu Bakr so much that we could not make out the front of his face from the back. He was bleeding and he fell unconscious. And those that took him to his home said, we were 100% sure we're taking a janazah home, that the next day he will not make it. The next day when he opened his eyes, he never asked who hit me. He never asked why they hit me. He never asked where am I. There was only one thing on the tongue of Abu Bakr. Kayfa Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. How is the Prophet of Allah? How is Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? His name is actually Abdullah Abdurrahman. However, Abu Bakr is his kunniya, and it is a name that he's given to him because Bakr means young camels. And Abu, it means the father of. Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu was a very soft man, tender person, and he would love to go every morning and feed the young camels. Hence the name Abu Bakr. Imam Nawawi rahmatullah alayhi mentions that Abu Bakr is actually, Bakr comes from the word early. Bukratan wa asila. Young camel because it's early in its age. So Bukr or Bakr means young. And Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu was always the first in goodness. If there was anything good, he was the Bakir. He was the one first stepping his door. Sayyidina Umar radiallahu anhu said, whenever I tried to compete with Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu in any goodness, he outdone me by far. Once Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that we are going to the battle of Tabuk, is there anyone that will give whatever he has? Umar radiallahu anhu said, I came with half my wealth. There was nothing in my home except I separated it into two halves. And I brought half of whatever I had. to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and I thought that probably today, if not overtake, at least I will be in par excellence to Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu. But when I came, I found that Abu Bakr brought everything from his home. Even the nails in his wall, he pulled them out and he gave that in sadaqah to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. The buttons of his shirt he pulled out and he gave that in sadaqah. And in emulation to him, the malaika was told to wear shirts with thorns as their buttons, because Abu Bakr used thorns to close up his clothes. My beloveds, these are the sacrifices of Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu. When Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wasallam went for Mi'raj, he came back from Mi'raj, no one would believe him. He met Abu Jahl and he said, "Oh Abu Jahl, last night I went for a travel and Allah ta'ala took me to the seven skies and this is what I seen. Believe." Abu Jahl made mock of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. "We cannot even travel a day or two on the speed that you are saying. You conquered Jerusalem in one night and then you want me to believe you went to the skies, the heavens and came back?" He went out and began to laugh and make joke of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. He came past Abu Bakr. Abu Bakr at that time still never meet the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. He said, "Do you hear what qala sahibukum, what your companion says? This is what he done and this is how he traveled." Abu Bakr said, "Awa qalaha?" Did he say it? He said, "Qalaha," he said it. He said, "In qalaha faqad saddaqtu." If he said what you said, the riwayat is not the riwayat is da'if. The riwayat is not authentic. It's via Abu Jahl. Who's the rawi? Who's the narrator of the hadith? Abu Jahl. I'm hearing it from Abu Jahl, from Rasulullah. He said, "If the Prophet said what you said, I have believed." The ulama said, Abu Jahl heard it directly from the Prophet. He never believed it. Abu Bakr heard it via Abu Jahl and he believed it. And what he said? He said, "Every day the wahi comes from the top down. If today instead of coming from the top down, Muhammad went up, what is so difficult? The pathway is clean. Jibreel is coming every day." And hence he was given this title of Siddiq. Siddiq, the person that truthfully believed and obeyed Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam is in Madinatul Munawwara. It's the end of his life. The ayat, "Idha ja'a nasrullahi wal fath," is revealed. Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wasallam sees everyone is cherishing. Everyone is in ecstasy. Because the ayat says, "Yadkhuluna fi deenillahi afwaja." People will come into the religion in droves. Who doesn't want to see a lot of Muslims? But one man was crying. In one corner was Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu. "Wama yubkika ya Aba Bakr, ka'annaka qad na'aka rabbuk." "O Prophet of Allah, your mission is completed. If everyone is coming to deen, there's no need for you." In this surah, I get the subtle message that Allah is calling you back to Him. Allah is calling you back to Him. Your work is done. Everyone has accepted Islam now. He cried. Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wasallam is very ill. Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu personally goes and looks after Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam every day. Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wasallam spelt it out very clearly that no one else will be leading the people in salah but Abu Bakr. He gave such preference to Abu Bakr. Whenever he went anywhere, he said, "Dakhaltu ana wa Abu Bakr wa Umar." Me and Abu Bakr and Umar went here. Me and Abu Bakr and Umar done that. He said, every Nabi has two wazirs in the skies and in the heaven and in the earth. My two wazirs in the skies is Jibra'il and Mika'il. And my two wazirs in this world is Abu Bakr and Umar. Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, one day he held Abu Bakr's hand on the right and Umar's hand on the left. And as he was walking, he said, "How me and him and them two are walking right now in the same order. We both, all three of us will enter Jannah together." Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that about Jannah. In the world they were together. Even in the alam barzakh, they are both buried at the feet of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. My beloved Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said about him, he said to Aisha radiallahu anha, "O Aisha, muri Aba Bakrin, falyaumma bin nas." "O muri Abak, tell your father, I'm too ill, I can't walk to the masjid. He must, subhanallah, lead the people in salah." Aisha knew radiallahu anha very well that the Imam of Medina is the Imam of the Muslims. If he has to lead the Muslims in prayer and something happens to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, then he will become the Imam of the Muslims. And she did not want the weight of the responsibility of the entire ummah on the shoulder of Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu. So she said to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, إِنَّهُ رَجُلٌ بَكَّاءَ. Abu Bakr cries a lot. He will be in salah, alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen, begin to cry, he won't finish the salah. Nabiya Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِنَّهُ مِنْ كَيْدِكُنَّ. This is from your extraordinary skills as women to plan. You're trying to override me. I'm not saying it. يَعْضَ اللَّهُ إِلَّا أَبَا بَكَرْ. Allah will not allow anyone to stand on that musalla after his Nabi except Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu. No one had the illustrious privilege and prestige to be mentioned in the Quran with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam but Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu. That when they were coming for the hijrah and they came up the mountain of Thawr is very steep. And subhanAllah, it's around a 2.5 hour climb. In the hostile heat of Makkah, Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu went down. He put Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam on his back. The Prophet was very ill and he tiptoed so the foot does not leave any imprints. He tiptoed up the mountain with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam on his back. He came, he put him and he said, Ya Rasulullah, give me sunayhat until I can go in and clean up the place. He then came out. Nabiya Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was burning in the sun. There was still one hole left. He could not find an object to put it in. He put his feet and subhanallah, a snake bit him. The riwayat is there. His tears fell on the face of Rasulullah. Nabiya Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Oh, Abu Bakr, what is it? He said, Uja, I can feel pain. He said, release. When he released, there was a snake. The riwayat has that snake even spoke to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The Prophet of Allah then took his saliva. He put it on that injured place of Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu. And it was restored and he got shifa. My beloved subhanallah, when he saw the feet of the Meccans walking past, he began to shiver and shake. Not for his own self, but for the safety of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, La tahzan, don't be grieved, O Abu Bakr. Inna Allaha ma'ana. We are not two, we are three. Allah is with us. This entire scene is drawn by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in such a beautiful way in the Quran al-Kareem. Umar radiallahu anhu said, I am ready to give my entire life of good action in lieu of those moments of Abu Bakr with Rasulullah in the cave of Thawr. So Sayyidina Umar radiallahu anhu, Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu is there. He's going to make the imamate. A lady came to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and said, Ya Rasulullah, I have a need. He said, I'm not feeling well. Come again tomorrow. She said, what if I come tomorrow? You don't look well at all. What if you expire? Who will I see then? He said, you will find Abu Bakr sitting in my place. You will find Abu Bakr sitting in my place and Abu Bakr will fulfill what I will fulfill. So Nabiya Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam made enough indication that Abu Bakr is the man to replace him after. When Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that Monday morning fell a little bit well, Abu Bakr was neglecting his other wife that was living far away and he was also neglecting his farms. For verily several days he only spent on the side of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It was time for him when he saw that Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gained some, you know, energy and he saw that Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was better. He said, I want some, you know, respite. And he took time off to go and rejuvenize himself and rejuvenate himself to come back. But subhanallah, Allah wished it. In that absence of Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam breathed his last. He said, Lo, ittakhadtu khaleelan lattakhadtu Abu Bakr. If I had to take a friend, I would have taken Abu Bakr. But I don't have any friends in this world. My only friend is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. My beloveds, Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu comes back. When he comes, Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has already passed on. He comes into the room. The entire Medina is shaken. The great, courageous knights on the battlefield that the Kuffar and the Romans would fear, the Umar and the Khalid bin Walid were all broken, crying on the Musalla. No one could pick up his head. Abu Bakr was the most hurt. This was his Nabi. He was the first believer, but he held himself strong for the Ummah. He kissed Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam on his forehead. He said, Tibta hayyan wa mayita, O Prophet of Allah, just as how you are beautiful, my Nabi. You are beautiful when you are living. You're so beautiful even after you passed away. He then came. Umar radiallahu anhu took out the sword. Man qala anna rasulallahi mayyit. If anyone says the Prophet hasn't passed away, I will cut his head. Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu was the only man that could calm Umar down. Made him sit. Got onto the mimbar and said, ما كان محمد محمد إلا رسول. He's a Nabi of Allah. قد خلت من قبله الرسل. If you were believing in Rasulullah as your deity, then know that he has died today. The only person that is everlasting is Allah. But Muhammad is a Rasul of Allah. We follow his sunnah and we will meet with him inshallah in Jannah. He brought the ummah back onto its tracks. No one knew many things about Rasulullah except Abu Bakr. People did not know where to bury Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Abu Bakr said, Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam whispered in my ear. And he told me, Abu Bakr, a Nabi is always buried where he dies. We will bury him on the ground where he passed away. No one knew about the inheritance of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Abu Bakr said, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, we are ma'sharul anbiya. We are not inherited in the dirham and the dinar. What we leave is for the Muslims in general. We leave a greater inheritance, and that is ilm and deen. Then they did not know how to make the janazah salah about Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Abu Bakr radiyallahu anhu told them that he is imamul anbiya. No person can be his imam. Even when 124,000 anbiya was there on the night of Mi'raj, he was the imam. We cannot make imamate over him. Everyone will pray his individual janazah on the side of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Amongst many, many other things, Abu Bakr was the first to know all the answers which no other person could even match. My beloved, subhanallah, what can I say about Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu? There's the poet says, Parwane kam hom, parwane kam hom, bulbul ke gulbas, siddiq akbar khuda ke rasul bas. Just as how that nightingale becomes overwhelmed and forgets the world as he's eating the pollen of that flower. Just as how that moth forgets about its life and throws itself in that fire. More than that, Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu sacrificed everything of his for Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. One day Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam is standing. He looks at the skies and he sees the thousands of galaxies and stars. And he says to Aisha radiallahu anha, can you see? She says, Ya Rasulullah, is there any single person in this world, in your ummah, that has so many good actions to match the stars in the horizon? And she was thinking, he will say, her father, Abu Bakr. Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, yes, Umar. Umar's good actions is so many. So she frowned, and what about my father? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, is not all the good actions of Umar equal to one good action of your father? Do you know what Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam said about him? Inna Allah sayatajalla linnasi aammatan wa sayatajalla li Abi Bakrin khassatan. In Jannah there will be a general presence of all Muslims with Allah, but when it comes to Abu Bakr, Allah will give him a private chamber to meet. Allah will give him a private chamber to meet. My beloved, Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam said about him, me and you, our heart's desire is only if we can get a whiff, a sniff, and a smell of Jannah. And even one door can open itself for us. Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, O Muslim, whilst your wish is to enter from one door of Jannah, the 8 doors of Jannah will wish that Abu Bakr enters from it. May Allah grant us all tawfiq to emulate them. Tomorrow we'll speak about the great Umar, inshallah.